player's requests, and the first piece is also a player request. So you'll notice that throughout the whole season, if you're looking at the programs throughout the next 4 weeks, we've got a couple of pairs. We're starting off the season with a solo cello piece by Neal Cary, and we're ending the season, bookending it, with a solo cello piece by Neal Cary. Kind of did that intentionally. We have a pair of Alan Blank pieces to hear. We have a pair of premieres to be heard, one of which you are about to hear right now. Along those lines, I'd like to welcome the composer, Frank Zindler. And Frank, if you'd like to come up and say a few words about the piece. The piece you're about to hear is by this gentleman here, Frank Zindler.
Well, two things. You really shouldn't applaud until you've heard the music. Secondly, I have to thank him for calling me a composer. Most people think that I was born about two centuries too late to be a composer because of the old-fashioned type of music that I composed or tried to write. I want to thank Neal and John, first of all, for the wonderful opportunity. I never thought I'd hear this, but to be able to have a hearing for this piece. It was written originally for my wife as just a piano solo on the occasion of our 10th anniversary in 1974. Anne was very fond of Chopin. She really liked the waltzes, and she was quite fond of the mazurkas. And so when you hear this, I think you will hear some echoes of Chopin, of the waltzes and the mazurkas. One of my Russian colleagues at work, who was training as a ballet dancer in Moscow, when I played this for her, just the piano thing, she sat very soberly and listened. And when it was over, she said, "I cannot dance to this." And she says, "It is only partly waltz." And I said, "Well, mazurka." "Yes, mazurka," she says. So you probably will hear that. I would like to say then also that it was kind of unusual that this came about in this form. About 2 years after my wife died, I finally got the courage to go through all of her materials that she had saved in a particular dresser drawer. And I found a cassette tape of me playing this waltz back in 1974. And a friend of mine converted to a digital form, and I then thought, I need to send this to somebody. And Neal Cary was the first person I thought of. But I thought, if I said this to him, what's he going to say? He might write back and say, you know, can you do anything better than chopsticks? And but I got up my courage, and I sent him as an email attachment. And the next day, a note came back, "Frank, this is a really nice piece. Have you thought about arranging this as a duet for cello and piano?" Well, no, I hadn't even imagined such a thing. My own cello playing, I never got past the last chair of the orchestra, literally. And the thought that I could hardly play on the piano, and the thought of doing this on the cello, requires truly virtuosic skill. And so, because he was interested, I did work it out, and I added a little introduction, which is sort of the idea of trying to retrieve memories of a happier time. And that is what I would like to say about the piece, but I need to make one important correction to the flattering program notes that you have before you. It says that I speak fluently 20 languages. Actually, I only speak a couple languages at any particular period of my life, but I do read 20 languages as part of my job. And so that, and I'm only scientific stuff in 20 languages. So that's an important bit of correction. But anyway, I hope you will enjoy it.
Thank you.